What's up internet, I am Manish from RebellionRider.com and I am back once again with another PL SQL tutorial. Today's tutorial is all about PL SQL collection method extend. We have seen a small and brief introduction to procedure extend in PL SQL tutorial 55, but today we will learn about it in detail. So sit back and enjoy the video. Before doing the example, let's first learn what is collection procedure extend in Oracle database. Collection method extend is an overloaded PL SQL procedure which is used for appending elements to the collection. As it is an overloaded procedure, thus it can be called in three different ways. First, extend procedure call without any argument. Calling PL SQL collection procedure extend without any argument will append a single null element to the collection. Second, extend procedure call with one argument. Calling PL SQL procedure extend with one argument will append the number of null elements that you mentioned as the argument of the extend procedure. Remember that argument must be a valid integer value. Third, extend procedure call with two arguments. In this case, the first argument indicates the number of elements that will be appended to the collection. The second argument is the index number whose value will be copied and assigned to each of the newly appended element of the collection. Collection procedure extend can only be used with the PL SQL collections nested table and VREs. It cannot be used with the collection associative array. That is a brief introduction to the PL SQL collection method extend. Now, before writing the example, I just want to take a quick second to ask you to smash that thumbs up button and like this video. Also, if you are new here on this channel, then go ahead and subscribe. That being said, let's write the example now. That is a very simple code. In this PL SQL block, we have created a nested table. Then using the collection variable nt_obj, we have assigned a numeric value to the first index of this collection. Also, using the output statement, we have displayed this stored value back to the user. This code seems perfect. So now, let's execute and see the result. An error? Subscript beyond count? Everything was perfect, then what went wrong? We have declared, defined and initialized the nested table, then what is missing? Take a deep breath, because there is nothing wrong with this code. It's just that we have declared, defined and initialized our collection, but memory for storing data has not yet been allocated to the collection. In case if you haven't initialized the collection, then before storing the elements into it, you first have to make slots into the memory for holding the data. To do that, we use PL SQL collection procedure extend. So let's try to solve this error by modifying the above code. We called the PL SQL collection procedure extend right before storing the value into the collection. As this is a simple extend procedure call without argument, thus it will append only one null element to the collection. Which means we will get the same error if we try to add more than one element to this collection. Now let's execute and see the result. Here we have our desired result. Now say we want to add three elements in our collection. In that case, we can use PL SQL collection procedure extend with single parameter. Let's see how. The first statement of the execution block is the procedure call with a single argument, and that argument is 3. This indicates that we can append maximum up to 3 elements to the collection. In the next 3 statements, we assigned values to the first 3 indexes of the nested table. And in the last 3 statements, we displayed those values back to the user. Although here we did everything explicitly, however, if you want, then you can use loop to automate this work. Let's execute and see the result. Here is our result. That's how we call a collection procedure extend with no argument and with 1 argument. Another way of calling procedure is with 2 arguments. Let's modify this code and see how to call PLSQL collection method extend with 2 arguments. As you know, the first argument in the extend procedure call will be the number of elements which will get appended to the collection. The second argument is the index number whose value will get copied and assigned to each of those newly appended elements. Which means we will need an index already holding some value so that we can use this index as our second argument. So let's start and modify the execution section of this code. Using the extend procedure call without argument, we just appended the first element of the nested table. Also, we have stored a numeric value which is 28 to it. Now, we will pass this index as our second argument to the procedure call. Let's do it. Here we have our extend procedure call with 2 arguments. The first argument is 5, which means 5 elements will be appended to our nested table. And the second argument is 1, which means the value assigned to the index 1, which is 28, will be copied and assigned to each of those newly appended 5 elements. To check that, we have an output statement which will display the value stored at the index 4 in our nested table. Let's execute and see the result. Here is our result. As you can see, the value stored at index 4 is 28, which is the value stored at index 1. So, these are all the 3 ways of calling PLSQL collection method extend in Oracle database. You can read the blog on the same topic for all the questions and answers which you could face in your certification exam or interview. And if you enjoyed watching, then share this video with your friends on your social media. Also, do make sure to like and subscribe. You can also connect with me on my Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. All the links are in the description. That is the tutorial on PLSQL collection method extend in Oracle database. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.